We'll have to come back to that story about a llama with a split personality in just a moment. We're crossing now to that cliff face at Moongase Cove, where authorities have been waiting for several days, staking out a hidden door, believed to be the entrance to the lair of the world-famous computer hacking genius, only known by his screen name, the Spatula. The breaking news there is that a superhero has arrived to help the police crack that mysterious access panel by the door that has been confusing detectives for some time. We'll cut live now to Beth Lahem to give us more information about the Cape Crusader. Miss Lahem?
Well, Brian, things started happening down here at Moongase Cove as a caped figure trotted up and offered his assistance to the police.
He didn't fly?
No, he just pranced up. Here he is now, sir.
What's up, dude?
What do you like to be known as, sir?
90s man, cowabunga!
The detectives behind us look close to cracking that code now. In what way have you assisted them?
It's just a game of columns.
Columns? Sounds confusing.
Nah, it's quite easy once you get the hang of it. Saw the display screen on the news and thought I'd cruise down. You see, if it is this Spatula dude, he's got a Mega Drive operating system.
Is that an advanced system? It must be, considering this might be the Spatula's lair.
Well, it's quite the opposite, which is why he's evaded everyone so successfully. Rather than use the latest technology, he's gone backwards, and most of the law were just babies when the Mega Drive come out, if they were even born. You see, it's just a little black box. It looks like it's got a steering wheel, but it doesn't. Careful, guys. The gem's starting to drop pretty quick. Just keep that mantra going in your mind. It's not bejeweled. It's not bejeweled. It's not bejeweled.
Amazing events unfolding there, Beth. Can you ask 90s man about those clothes he's wearing?
90s man? That outfit, that device, can you tell us about this alien-like paraphernalia?
Yes, certainly. What do you want to know?
Well, how about that massive helmet for a start?
Okay, we'll start there and work down. This is me stack hat. Protects the head, hurts the neck. The hair there, shaved all round but long on top.
Very interesting.
That's called an undercut. Good for whipping people in the face and eyes and stuff. Stings. Got pretty limited range, especially when I'm wearing me stack hat.
And how about this amazing looking shirt?
Oh, it's a hypercolour shirt.
Wow, a chameleon-like vest to blend in with your environment.
Sort of. Nah, it just changes from pink to blue when you touch it. Pretty cool.
Your pants?
Parachute pants.
To help you float back to Earth if you're plummeting to certain death?
Nah, just a bit voluminous.
Your shoes? An ejector button in the tongue there to blast you to safety.
These are pumps. They raise you up a few millimetres. Bit more comfy.
So not as super and powerful as...
Well, it's antique, that's the point. See, this is me Walkman. Gets me in the mood. Accidentally Kelly Street. Happy birthday, Helen.
Sorry?
Sonia Dada?
No, sorry. How about this?
That's me pop ball. One of me main weapons, along with giving him a wedgie.
It looks like half a tennis ball.
Yeah, but it stings like a bastard. Look.
Oh! That's left a red mark.
See? Told ya. Yeah! High five, dudes! High five! Don't leave me hanging.
Beth, sorry to interrupt. It looks like something's going on behind you.
Yes, Brian. It appears the columns game has been conquered and it looks like some sort of yellow plastic strip leading down into the dark with water rushing down it.
Amazing scenes there, Beth.
You're quite right there, Brian. The authorities have managed to crack the first stage of the Spatula's lair.
Let's move in.
Wait, don't go down.
Why not?
It's a trap. You'll get sore knees.
What should we do?
It's a slip and slide. Get some detergent, make it more slippy.
Thanks, 90s man.
Eat my shorts!